वेलकम टू माइक्रोवेव एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक्स लेक्चर सीरीज। आई प्रोफेसर रितेश धोलकिया इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू स्मिथ चार्ट एग्जांपल फॉर VSWR, रिफ्लेक्शन कोएफिशिएंट, लोड इम्पीडेंस, मैक्सिमम इम्पीडेंस एंड वी मीन कैलकुलेशन इन दिस वीडियो। सो लेट अस हैव अ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन एंड इन दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन हियर वी हैव लोड इम्पीडेंस। This transmission line length is given by 3 lambda by 8. Precisely, it is 0.375 lambda. And here we have been given with input impedance, that is minus J2.5. And here we are dealt with to calculate VSWR, reflection coefficient, load impedance, maximum impedance and V mean. And here impedance is given in normalized form. So as impedance is given in normalized form, we are not dealt with to translate given impedance in normalized impedance. Usually if it is not given in terms of normalized impedance, then before we place points in Smith chart, we need to normalize those impedance by dividing characteristic impedance. So here we have Smith chart, you can see, and in this Smith chart initially, we will be placing this input impedance point, that is minus J2.5. So we need to identify normalized input impedance, but it is already normalized, that is given in question. So this is our input impedance, that is minus J2.5. Now, if you observe this Smith chart, then in this Smith chart, these are real circles you see. And these are imaginary circles. Now, this upper portion of imaginary circles are positive imaginary circles, and this lower portion of imaginary circles are negative imaginary circles. Now, in this, first we are dealt with to identify Z in point, which is minus J's 2.5, and that is having real value which is 0. So if you observe, see, this is the circle which is having 0 real value, which is largest one, right? And imaginary component is minus J2.5. So here you see this is negative imaginary circles, and minus J2.5 that comes somewhere over here, right? So this is our Z in point, you see, that is minus J2.5. Now, once we have Z in point with respect to center, we can make a circle that will be our VSWR circle. So first we will be plotting VSWR circle by considering center over here, and radial point is Z in. So you see, now I'm plotting this VSWR circle, as you can see it over here. So by this black color, we have VSWR circle. Now from this VSWR circle, we are dealt with to stretch a straight line on this data. So I'm just stretching straight line. You see, I have stretched it. The reason is we want to identify VSWR and reflection coefficient. Now you see, this line is intersecting to this first axis, that is identifying VSWR value. And if you observe this VSWR, then that is infinite. For this outermost VSWR circle, you will be finding VSWR value is infinite. And on this third axis, you see there is reflection coefficient. So the value of reflection coefficient is 1 over here. So now we got two answers. One is VSWR, that is infinite for this case, and reflection coefficient, that is 1 for this case. Now third question is to identify load impedance. Now see, load impedance that we identify by moving our position. Now if you observe, here we have been given with input impedance. So here we are dealt with to move in this direction, and this direction is towards the load direction. So towards the load direction, that is there in anti-clockwise direction in Smith chart. So first we will be stretching line from center to input impedance. So draw a straight line from center to input impedance. Now you see I have drawn a straight line from center to input impedance. And now in anti-clockwise direction, we are little bit to move by 3 lambda by 8 distance. And then we will be finding a point of intersection to VSWR. So now from this point in anti-clockwise direction, by 0.375 lambda, we are little bit to move. So if you move by 0.375 lambda, you will be finding this point that is intersecting to VSWR circle over here, right? And when you do this movement by 0.375 lambda like this, at that time, carefully you will have to see this circle of VSWR where data is given in terms of movement. So here I have directly shown, like, see, this is 0.375 lambda, but when you calculate at that time, you will have to carefully note down that data exactly and precisely. So now that point comes somewhere over here and I'm stretching line towards center. And now this line intersects to VSWR circle over here. So as this is intersecting over here, this is outermost circle. So real part of this point is zero. And if you observe imaginary part, then imaginary part is approximately 0.425, which is over here, right? So this is the point which is our load impedance. So as if you move towards the load in anti-clockwise direction from input, you will be finding load impedance, which is minus J0.425 in this particular case. Now, what about maximum impedance? So one should understand in Smith chart, maximum impedance that happens at this point, right? So here you see at this point, this VSWR circle is intersecting over here. So here as it is intersecting over here, one can say here impedance will be infinite. So that will be our maximum impedance. And to have understanding of V-mean point, so V-mean is happening at this coordinate. So here VSWR circle is interacting at this point over this side. So this will be the point where we'll be having V-mean point. See, V-mean and maximum impedance that we identify to understand what will be the location of maxima and minima. So here you'll be finding maxima locations will be there, and here you'll be finding minima locations will be there. At minima location, we'll be having coordinate of V-mean, so that is over here. And maximum impedance, or one can say Vmax point, that will happen in VSWR over this side. So that is somewhere over here. So that is how we identify locations of maximum impedance, V-mean in Smith chart. I hope you have understood this. If you have any query regarding this, you just place your queries in comments so that I can understand the things which is happening in terms of understanding along with my dear students. And you can download all these questions which I am teaching over here from my application Engineering Funda, where I have shared PDF of all Smith chart example which I have solved it on YouTube channel. And even for future videos, you can give your perspectives so that I can make sure our students can learn properly and they can have proper understanding out of learning from the channel Engineering Funda. Thank you so much for watching this video.